Let's record an invoice to one of our customers. First, select Sales, and then Customers. The Customers list is a list of people that we sell things to, and it also gives us the current balance for each one of our customers. So right here we can see how much money all of our customers owe us. Though it isn't required, you can set up a customer ahead of time before you create an invoice for them by clicking on New Customer. If you do that, you'll be able to enter their address and other information that will be populated onto the invoice later on when you create it. Let's create an invoice for one of our existing customers by selecting the Create menu and then clicking Invoice. The first thing we have to enter for an invoice is the customer. So here we'll select Thomas A. Waits. Notice that QuickBooks automatically populates both the billing address and also the email address for this customer because we entered them onto the customers list ahead of time and entered all of that information. If you wish to send the invoice to multiple people, you can add a comma right here and enter a second email address, or you can add a CC or BCC by clicking on this link. QuickBooks also gives you the ability to send a Pay Now button to the customer by selecting either one of these options to accept payment by credit card or free bank transfer. Down here we enter the date details of the invoice, including terms, which is the number of days that a customer has to pay the invoice, and then the invoice date, which is usually the date that you're issuing the invoice, and the due date. Down in the products and services area, enter what it is that you're charging the customer for. So right here in the top product and service area, we'll enter trimming. Notice that the description and the amount for this line are automatically populated onto the form. That's because they were set up ahead of time on the products and services list to make it much easier to enter invoices later on. You can continue to add more products and services that you're charging the customer for right here. Scrolling down, there are more options on this invoice. For instance, right here we can enter a message to be displayed on the invoice that we send to our customer, and we can also include a statement memo, which is something to keep track of for ourselves and will also appear later on if we end up sending a statement to the customer at a later date. You have several options for saving this invoice. First, you can save your progress and keep on working on the invoice. You can also save and close the invoice, which saves the transaction and then brings you back to whatever it was you were doing before entering this transaction. We also have save and share a link, which saves the invoice and simply sends a link to the customer so they can view the invoice. Save and send, which saves the invoice and emails the customer, and then also save and new, which allows us to save the invoice and create another invoice immediately afterward. Let's save and send. Right here, you can see the subject of the email being sent to the customer, as well as the body of the email, and a preview of what it is they'll see on the invoice itself over here on the right. Now send and close. QuickBooks confirms that the email was sent out to our customer, and now scrolling down, here we can see this customer's name along with the amount that they currently owe us. Now we just sit back and wait for our customer to pay us.